So what's up, y'all? It's your boy Studio Matt. I'm back again, crypto news with my man over here, Courtney Rhines. He's a crypto analyst. I've been learning a lot from this brother for like many months now, and he's pretty much learning and growing with me. You know what I'm saying? But he's the man, so we got him here, man. Everybody,
we're trying to learn it all together. As we learn it together, we're just gonna get the information out to y'all.
Yeah.
So a lot of this stuff, we could even say some information that might not be 100%, and then in the comments you can correct us, and that's what we're all here for, one big group. You know, we might, some numbers might be off or something, or some little technical analysis might be off that you might know, then you just throw it in and
let us know about it. Please let us know, because we're going to make some money off of it, and we're going to help y'all make money too, and that's what we all here for, to make money, learn, and grow. Also remember, money not the power. Knowledge is the power. Money is just a tool.
So money is just a tool. What is the date today?
Today is, I believe, the 20th. No, it's the 19th.
The 19th. Because the date is, you got to remember that what we're talking about today, the date specifically matters. So like today's the 19th.
May 19th.
Right? Everybody wakes up to 2021. Everybody wakes up and boom, everything is down.
Man, I woke up.
Everything is down.
I'm talking thousands of dollars. But I ain't break a sweat. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, at the same time, I was a little like, man, I wish I would have swung it. For all you cats that's did your swing, shout out to you, good job. I wish I would have swung a little more. I did swing some, but I didn't swing at all. But man, it would have been a lot of money made.
Me, myself, I'm not a swinger. I just hold. I'm holding, period. Okay. I don't do any of that. I get with what I believe in, and then I hold it. There's the only two ways to do this. You either buy something and hold it, or you swing around with it. Dips, highs and lows. Oh, it went up 20%. You made 20%. Sell it. Oh, it dropped back down. Then when it dropped back down, use your 20% that you just made, put it back in there and ride it back up. That's what he's doing. Both effective, and then you just do it, which one works out best for you. So yeah. You just kind of
got multiple accounts too, but man, we got to let people know what's going on right now with Bitcoin. Everything is dropping, like everybody's going crazy.
Everything's like, mad. Here, let me show you.
I didn't go crazy. I know you asked me about that. I didn't go crazy. I didn't sell.
Right, right.
I did.
But what happened is when what's actually going on right now is people are selling.
Man,
you didn't sell. So there's a lot of people looking at their portfolio and they're seeing those numbers drop, and then they wake up day before yesterday and they seen them drop some more, and these are a lot of new investors, and then today,
man,
they wake up and they see it drop anymore. So for instance, if you had $10,000 or something, and then you wake up and you see that you only got $2,000 and you're new to this and you don't know what's going on, you immediately don't want to lose your $2,000, so you sell and you say, I'm gonna at least get $2,000. Wow. So I don't lose everything.
Man,
that's what's going on right now with the majority of investors right now. A lot of investors is new to this. They heard all the pump with Dogecoin and all of that stuff, so they jumped in and they made some money, and then the market flipped right here and it turned around on them, which we'll get into why, and then it went down, so everybody's selling. So when everybody sells, it drives all the prices down.
People are selling, but I'm also seeing it go back up sometime during the day. So people are selling, people are buying. People are confused right now. That's what I'm getting.
Right.
People are
right.
Very confused. They want to know what the hell is going on. So as a real crypto analyst, like what type of things will happen where Bitcoin will drop this low?
So
because that's crazy to me.
So there's a couple of things. First of all, there's a few things. There's a pattern, and then there's the news, right? So in the last week, we've been dealing with Elon Musk and all of this stuff with
Doge
and Bitcoin and all this and all that. Now, he started making tweets because obviously people listen to what he says. And since they don't have any regulations right now or cryptocurrency, so he's not quite insider trading or manipulating. You can't do this with the stock market. Like Phil Nike can't be like, he can't come out and say something about Nike.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? And then put out a fresh new pair of Nikes or something. You know what I'm saying? Because you're manipulating by what you say manipulates the stock.
Yeah.
But this isn't in crypto. So Elon Musk can make a quote about something. And obviously he's doing it with Dogecoin. And then people are buying it and it's going up. And Dogecoin to the moon. And whatever he says, people weigh on it.
To the moon stuff is so funny to me.
since he's a, but he's the richest man in the world. So obviously, if the richest man in the world is saying something, they people are gonna listen to that.
Oh, facts.
But people are starting to also realize that you could be the richest man in the world, but you don't know particular everything about a topic.
Yeah.
So now let's get back to what he's doing. What he's doing as of lately is he was saying that Bitcoin is bad for the environment. It's not environmentally friendly. Now,
that's funny to me. I'm like, this is just some crypto. This is digital, right?
Digital, right, right. So it got, but that goes back to how, to mining stuff. How is this stuff mined? The energy consumption of how it's mined. Mm. So that's where they're talking about that Bitcoin is consuming all this energy, which it's not, which it's not, which everyone now, by now, they're going to look into this and they're going to see it's not. And then I don't want to throw cheap shots at nobody. I'm not even into the whole energy thing, but the electric cars, in order to have an electric car from Elon Musk, you have to go get coal. There's way more coal being burnt than there is in the Bitcoin mining. So, but that's a whole nother topic.
Okay.
But he talks, when he says these things, then people sell their stock. Oh, yeah. It's bad. It's, and then he said he's not going to use Bitcoin, let you purchase Tesla with Bitcoin. That is because he's going to have some contracts with the government for clean energy. So that makes sense business-wise.
Mm.
But it doesn't make sense if you're stating false information.
He's like cutting out the competition?
He's cutting out the competition towards getting those government contracts.
Okay.
If I want the government contract for clean, for green energy,
yeah,
right? And then I'm saying that Bitcoin is not green energy. Well, then now I'm going to say Bitcoin is not good.
Mm.
Or not necessarily, you see what I'm saying? I'm going to say it's not good. So now I get this, so I get the contract from the president.
Gotcha.
Okay, so that's business wise.
That makes sense.
And then that's why people are selling their stock. But if you also look today, and it's, what time is it right now? It's 11:30.
Yeah.
A couple hours ago, Elon Musk tweeted, Diamond Hands.
Mm.
So,
facts.
So,
I've seen that.
So now, let's talk about the manipulation part again. Because if this was stocks right there, he's in trouble. Because what he says manipulates the stocks. A week ago, he tells you that Bitcoin is not energy effective and it's bad for the environment and he's not going to use it with Tesla, this and that and this and that. And that Tesla is selling a percentage of their stock. Oh, so now the regular person thinks that it's bad. So he sells his too.
You're right.
So he sells his too.
Right.
So he sells his too. Then, a few days later, he says, yeah, but I'm not selling the remainder of my Bitcoin. You sold yours. But he said, I'm not selling the remainder of my Bitcoin. Okay? It's still bad. Now it's going down. Now it's going down some more. Now, when the price is going down, now you're not even listening to Elon Musk. You're looking at the price go down.
Yeah.
So now you're saying, oh man, I'm losing money. He said it's not that good. I need to get my money.
Right.
So now, and everyone's doing that. Who's new investors is doing that. They're pulling all their money out. Oh, I got to make sure I don't lose it all. I put $5,000 in. It's down to $2,000. I don't want to lose my remaining $2,000. Let me get out of here. All the people's doing that. This morning, Elon Musk says that he's not selling his. You sold yours. He's keeping his. So now the price went all the way down.
Man.
All the regular people who don't know how this is working and haven't studied the Bitcoin chart to know that it goes up 200% a year, but we're going to talk about that in another conversation. They know that it's going back up, so they're buying right now. It's basically a discount right now. And we got to understand that
Black Friday came early, yo.
Black Friday came early. You got to understand that there's Bitcoin, and then Bitcoin's the big dog of the whole altcoins and everything.
Right.
Nothing moves unless Bitcoin says so. So when Bitcoin catches a cold, everybody else catches a cold,
yeah,
and they chill.
Yeah.
When Bitcoin,
I'll say a nice 95% of the coins, you might catch one or two coins that wiggle
right
through it.
There's always going to be a few that's just
going to
do what they do.
The
but overall, when you look at the numbers on the top,
yeah,
they're all going down. Bitcoin go down, they all go down. Bitcoin go up, they all go up. Yeah. All right. The correction happened right now, and now it's about to go back up. So if you had a little bit of money and you dollar cost average and bought a little bit of whatever, you're gonna make money right now because your stocks and your coins are about to go back up. So what I would suggest, but I'm not a financial advisor, is whatever coins you already believed in now that you bought, buy some more of them because they're about to, it's all about to go back up.
Yeah.
So you buy
so
some
let
more.
Let me talk about that for a minute, because yep. This is my prediction with it going back up.
Okay.
The fact that it was up, I feel like it wasn't a whole lot of excitement because it wasn't like, oh, it just shot up, you know what I'm saying, 50,000.
Right. Right.
But now it just went down so far.
Right.
When it do shoot up 30,000 at a time, right. Now it's a lot more interesting for people to start getting
right.
involved.
And you got to remember,
so
too,
it
right
gave it more wiggle room.
Right before it dropped, Bitcoin was going sideways, meaning yeah. it wasn't on its way up right now.
Right, for a little bit, yeah.
Because we're in altcoin
yeah,
season.
All the altcoins.
When we're in altcoin season, Bitcoin chills. Because people's taking money out of Bitcoin, putting it into altcoins.
Yeah.
It's altcoin season. Everything's going up right now. So Bitcoin was supposed to chill right now, but it went down, and that's when the panicking
yeah.
started.
Yeah.
So that's where all the like mass hysteria started.
Definitely gave it a lot more wiggle room. I feel like when it does start going back up, everything start going back up, everybody's going to be excited.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Anybody that took their money out, they're going to be like remorseful, like, man, I got to get my money back in. Now it's going back up. You know
right.
And then all the people that was waiting, they like, oh yeah, now it's perfect time to get back.
There's
going to
be a whole lot of that
gonna
FOMO.
Be a lot of excitement.
There's a whole lot of terms and terminology like FOMO. FOMO is fear yeah. of missing yeah. out. So now these coins are going to start to go back up, and you're going to be sitting at home going, I sold that. And now you're watching it go back up.
Man.
And then now you're like, oh, I got to get back in. Boop. And then you got to get, you know, that's how
yeah,
it is.
I think everybody's done that before in their crypto or stock
yep.
journey.
That's the whole learning. That's a learning experience.
Yeah.
And a lot of these things we've already went through and we'll be telling you in the future because they're basic mistakes that the average person will do in the beginning of learning all of this stuff.
Yeah.
So a few of those things we already did, and we can just say, hey, watch out for this or watch out for that.
So this right here, we're going to sum it up on this episode, but make sure y'all stay tuned because we want to talk a little bit more about what happened in China. You know what I'm saying?
In China,
like,
yes.
We're going to save that for the next episode, but y'all make sure y'all hit the thumbs up, like button, all that, and please leave comments below, man. Let us know, what did y'all do? Did y'all hold or did you fold?
Did you hold or fold?
Did you hold or fold?